is certainly not afraid to mince her words and play politics in a bid to get exactly what she wants. Since joining the cast 2 years ago, this blonde biker has caused a stir, and her current goal of promotion to her dream job as a surgeon is rankling with the other staff.
I'm just concerned for Mr. Strachan, that's all.
I bet you are.
He's a friend and a colleague, and we joined at the same time.
And you have his best interests at heart.
I know he's very ill, and it seems to be taking its toll. I feel for him, I really do.
I have to go.
If there's anything I can do.
Such as?
I don't know, I'm just trying to do the right thing. Lend him my support.
But of course, if his position on Darwin were to become available, can you think of anyone who could step into his shoes?
His health should be the number one priority.
Which is why we're having this meeting.
So it's true.
As you say, Miss Naylor, we're all trying to do the right thing. I'll give him your best wishes.
Please.
Please welcome Rosie Marcel. Straight down to business, pole dancing.
Yes, come on.
Would
yes.
you?
Oh, absolutely.
Good
yes.
girl.
Absolutely. Definitely.
Have you?
Yeah. No.
yes, no.
No, I haven't. Yeah. I'd like to try it though.
What about the horn then?
The horn?
Yeah.
No, I tried playing instruments at school. I was no good. I play a bit of guitar, but that's about it. I'm the same as you. Have a brand new guitar and really trying to plunk away at it, and not very good.
Are there any sort of skills that you would like to acquire?
I'd like to learn to scuba dive, yeah, because I really want to do some more travelling before I have any children and stuff, so I think it'd be nice to be able to do the underwater bit as well.
Oh, yeah. But aren't you already a black belt in karate?
Yes. A very long time ago I got
that.
I couldn't beat anybody up now, certainly not. I'd probably slip a disc or something.
Did you learn it as self-defence or fitness?
Fitness. My mum kind of got me into it and my brother into it when we were younger because we were quite sort of hyperactive and stuff, and it really kept us calm and it was good.
That's a good idea actually, isn't it?
Yeah, it's really good for you.
Kids are hyperactive.
Yeah.
Learn how to fight.
It didn't help that we had a McDonald's afterwards though.
Yeah.
Didn't work out very well with the MSG afterwards. So
it's sort of in keeping with your character on the show, isn't it? She's so feisty.
Yeah,
she's pretty ruthless.
Very strong. Yeah, she's very. Oh, she could definitely have a fight. She'd win a fight, definitely. Not maybe not against Lola, but she'd definitely win a fight. Yeah.
Do you have to like a character in order to be able to play her, or do you have to find something to like about her?
I think you have to find something to like, because I think she's quite a despicable character. There's not a lot I like about her, to be honest. I mean, she's very honest, which is a nice thing. You know, it's good to be honest, but not. You've got to have internal dialogue, and she's got none. Whatsoever.
So what's it like playing Carol McGiffin?
It's good. It's good, you have a lot in common.
Do ruthless women get on in life, do you think, then? Is that...
I think they can do, yeah. I mean, it's about playing your cards right and doing it the right way. I think hurting people's feelings on the way is just completely wrong.
She's very unpopular, isn't she?
She's very unpopular. I get so much stick.
Yeah.
Oh, God, everybody hates me.
And do you get horrible letters and things?
Yes.
Oh, that's awful, isn't it?
I get lots of horrible letters and I get lots of people calling me nasty names in the street and stuff. But most people are like, I really hate you, but I really love you as well.
Yeah.
And they just want me to stop being horrible to Joseph.
And do you think she will... We will see the nice side of her eventually.
Yeah, you do actually. It's actually been written in, and I start being nice soon, whether it's truthful or not. We'll have to wait and see.
Any romance my own ends. Blossoming?
No, nobody wants to be with me. after the Lorburn debacle, it's very unlikely.
Really?
Yeah, there aren't any other 70-year-olds on the show either that I can sleep with, so it's not working out too well at the moment.
Now, in your personal life,
yeah.
You've met your chap on the set of another TV show, didn't
I
you?
I did, on The Vice, yeah, my husband, Scott.
Is he an actor?
He's not, he's a second assistant director.
Right, so does that work that you're both in the same business?
It does, I mean... In some ways, he keeps me very, very grounded, which is great. So I don't go home and complain and things like that because he'll tell me off straight away.
Right.
So it keeps me very, very level. But we haven't worked together since The Vice, so I'm not sure how it would work if we were actually working on the same set.
If he was directing you, you know, on a film or a show, would you be able to take orders, do you think?
I don't know. I'm probably not telling him to shut up, actually. But I think I'd like to think that we could do anything together. Because he's fabulous, so I think whatever we do
would
be great.
Take orders during the day while you were on set, and then make him pay for it when he got home.
Absolutely, yeah. Because really, I wear the trousers, so that's fine. Yeah, just keep it, you know, keep him professional at work.
And
definitely.
You actually went to Gretna Green, didn't you, to get married?
Yeah, we did. We eloped.
Oh.
Yeah.
Aww.
Yeah. Well, we didn't have any money, and we didn't want to sort of. I don't like being the centre of attention. That whole wedding thing kind of freaks me out a bit.
Your parents upset?
Well, my dad went and my brother went, and unfortunately my parents divorced, so it was difficult for me because I had to pick between the two of them. And because my brother doesn't talk to my mother, I wanted as many family as I could get there, so I had to kind of invite my dad and my brother, and my mum was upset, and my sister was upset because I wasn't talking to her either.
It sounds like a soap opera you should write.
I have a very, very disjointed family. It's terrible, but it was a wonderful day.
And you got your guy.
And I got my guy, and I got my dress, and I got in my jeans an hour later, which made me very happy.
Listen, we're very happy that you joined us today.
Thank you.
Holby City, Tuesday, 8 o'clock, BBC One, yes?
Yeah, that's
brilliant.
Right.
Thank you so much, Rosie Marcel.